How's it going, everybody? Andy McCullough from the Kansas City Star here at Great American Ballpark, where the Royals completed a two-game sweep of the Reds. It was not exactly exhilarating baseball, but you know, whatever. We don't really need to talk too much about tonight's baseball game. The broad strokes: Jeremy Guthrie pitched. He did not pitch particularly well. He's not a particularly great pitcher this season. He's not going to pitch in the postseason almost certainly, so it's just kind of counting down the days till October 8th when the Royals will host game one of the ALDS. Ben Zobrist has been great, four hits. He scored twice. Lorenzo Cain hit a two-run single, so there's your baseball game. The thing we wrote about today in the paper actually is kind of interesting. I mean, I feel like it's interesting. You know, there's a lot of people kind of snickering and making fun of Baseball Prospectus for their projections on the Royals. You know, and they projected them to win 72 games. Obviously, with the victory tonight, they won 73. It's August 19th. So it actually might be August 20th. I'm not sure what day it is. It's very late. I have a flight in 4 or 5 hours. But the interesting thing, you know, is I wanted to sort of talk to the people at BP about where this projection comes from and, like, why they may have been so wrong about the Royals. And so I talked with Sam Miller, the editor-in-chief at Baseball Prospectus, who is a friend of mine, I will say. And you know, he basically explained sort of how they come to this projection. And really, when you think about it, it's not a far-fetched thing. And we talked about this somewhat at the beginning of the year, but if you went around the Royals diamond at the start of 2015, the only above-average hitters, according to a simple metric like OPS Plus, were Lorenzo Cain and Alex Gordon. Everyone else was a below-average hitter. So when you put those numbers into the system, then they're not going to look good. And when you look at every member of the original starting rotation, and obviously they've been upgraded with Johnny Cueto, every member had an ERA that was a considerable amount lower than their FIP, which suggests that they're sort of possible for regression. And there's definitely, you know, regression candidates among the bullpen. So, you know, that's why it comes to, it's not like an anti-Royals bias or anything like that. It's that the Royals actually weren't a particularly statistically good team last season. They were a great team in terms of winning baseball games. They won they won 89 games. They played fantastic down the stretch. You know, they played great in the playoffs. But statistically, they were not a juggernaut. And so that's how, you know, sometimes when you look at these systems, they can end up with 72 wins. But I think, you know, the point is not so much to mock Baseball Prospectus, who I think does really good work, but just to understand the limitations of statistical projections. And so I hope we've all learned something today. In honor of Jeremy Guthrie, I'm going to go read a story about climate change in the New Yorker. You can read about everything related to the Royals in the page of the Kansas City Star, kansascity.com, and our True Blue app. Have a good night.